we have a work ethic of just not giving up, and I think that will help towards us sussing out, because we've got other people that can do each another's jobs. So if anyone switches off or doesn't know what to do, other people can fill that role. Don't get me wrong, it's going to be difficult, but you know, that's what football is sometimes, and we have to just match that energy and the performance, and hopefully we can try and get a result.
Yeah, and I suppose Ben, coming under, working with Darren, he's great in terms of his versatility to be able to switch things up in games. And have you been working that on training this week in terms of that flexibility to be able to change within games and to change from one formation to the next?
Yeah, we've been trying out different tactics and different formations we can switch to if things start to get difficult, or if we, our understanding of the situation starts to, you know, drop off. He's got great knowledge about the game and his team and staff as well. You know, in training, we've gone through a lot of pictures and situations that would be in a football, in a game situation, and how we could deal with it. So, yeah, we've definitely... been through it in terms of if things start to change, we know what we're doing as a team.
And I suppose every player won't admit to it, but probably secretly, when a manager leaves the club, that he's brought you in, he wants you to be their main guy. There's that bit of nervous, I wouldn't say nervous excitement, but there's that bit of nervous uneasiness for a day or two until you start to figure what was going on. Was that a difficult maybe 24 or 48 hours for you until you heard of Darren's appointment? And was we almost a sense of reassurement then when it was Darren that was coming in to take over from Neil? But that in between time between Neil and Darren, was that very nervous for you? Obviously, Neil headhunted you, he wanted you to be that guy, and then you're almost waiting in the wings to see what happens.
Yeah, definitely. It's obviously a nervous time for every single player, because obviously we didn't know what the situation was and what was going to happen, and because it happened so quickly, everyone was a bit, you know, on the back foot and defensive about it. But you know, that's football sometimes, and you know, a lot of clubs go through managers, and we're just glad as a team that, you know, Darren Moore's been able to take over, and he's such a good appointment for the club. And the players respect him so much, and we're all ready, you know, to kick on with him and show the league that we mean business.
Yeah, and finally, just on the Ipswich game again, they've shown they can win the games 1-0. They've shown they can win the games the 4-3, the 5-4s, 3-4. So any sorts of situation Ipswich have been in this sort of season so far under Kieran McKenna, if they go behind, if they can see goals, if it's sort of tight, cagey games, they always seem to find a way so far this season. So I suppose that was the key case for Huddersfield last year coming down the stretch under Neil Warnock. They always seem to find a way to grab a win. So is this sort of two teams coming up against each other this week that know how to get a result or dig out a result? And in terms of Ipswich, are you sort of prepared to know that they're never beaten, even if they go behind, that they have the capabilities of coming back and winning high scoring games as well?
Yeah, definitely. But I think obviously we understand that as well. Obviously, going from his last two games, you know, we've shown that we're not, you know, defeated, and we never give up. And I think it's definitely two teams coming up against each other that know how to get points out of the game. But it's just us understanding how to stop their strengths, and us exploiting our strengths into our performance. And hopefully it's a great game for both teams, and hopefully we can come out with a win.
Cheers, Ben. Thank you.